Hello, everybody. Andrea Twarowski here with Dentalelle Tutoring. Excuse the mess again. We have moved in and there's still tons of boxes everywhere. So sorry about that. But I was teaching a class last Friday, and I find that a lot of students have the same issue with one thing. I mean, not one thing. There are many things that are tricky and hard and overwhelming as a student, but this is something that if you don't do it right, it can mean a pass or fail. You know, it makes a big, big difference. And that's how you study. I was talking to so many students last Friday about sort of study tips, how to study properly, how not to study. So I will do sort of a recap in the video for you because all of them loved it. So there is such a thing as studying too much. There really is. Because if you're studying for, you know, hypothetically 8 hours a day, but you're not studying the right material, then all of that studying is not worth it. You are exhausted, you are annoyed, you feel like you learned nothing, and then you don't pass your test. So there is such a thing as studying too much, but there's also such a thing as not studying enough. If you study the day before your test, a day before your exam, and you don't pass, that's why, because you didn't have enough time to prepare yourself. But let me first talk about how there is such a thing as studying too much, because this could go a couple ways. It could be because you're not studying the right information, or it could be because you are not studying the right way. So let me talk about the right information first. So you need to be studying the right things. Let's take the board exam as an example. If you felt you had studied so much, you had studied everything, but you still didn't pass, it's likely because, and probably because, you aren't studying the right thing. So you might be wondering, well, how am I supposed to know what to study? You know, you have so many textbooks, you have so many notes from school, but that's where a tutor can help you. So if you need help, let me know. I've been teaching for the board exam for 13 years now, and my students have a 99.4% success rate. So I can tell you and show you exactly what to study. But the next thing is you might not be studying the right way. So you might be wondering, well, what the heck do you mean by that? Now, a lot of students think that if they, let's take class as an example. Let's take class. So after you learn a topic, you make notes in class. And then I find a lot of students go home and rewrite all of their notes, but that's not the best study plan for everybody. I'm not saying everybody, but for a lot of people, that's not the right way to do it, myself included. When I was a student, all of my classmates, that's how they would study, and they would get good marks. But when I tried that, I learned nothing. My hand was so sore after rewriting all of my notes for like 3 hours. And then I felt to myself, okay, so I didn't actually learn anything as I was writing them. So I guess I'm going to restudy that. So then you just have to read through your notes again and again and again. But before, when it took you 3 hours to rewrite those notes, that's 3 hours wasted. But again, not for everybody. So if that's how you have been studying and you're not passing, then that's not the method for you. You might need to use my method. And what I found worked for me was I would read my notes over and over and over and over again, literally. After a class, I would go home, read those notes per topic. For, let's say, a 2 hour class, it would typically take me 2 hours to read through all of those notes, depending on how many notes they had. But so prior to a test, I would typically start to study 2 weeks prior to a test. I would reread all of my notes. So day one, I would read all of those notes. It would take about 2 hours. And then day two, I would reread those notes that I did the day before. I still didn't feel like I was learning, but then by day three and day four, I was like, okay, now I'm starting to understand these notes. So for me, rereading them made the most sense, and that helped me get my high marks. So everybody's different. Another method is highlighting. So you might be the type of person who likes to read their notes from class, but then you need to go back in the textbook, highlight the important points, and then study those points. So that may work for you. That didn't work for me because I never knew what to highlight. Like, I would be highlighting the whole chapter, and then I'm thinking, okay, this isn't helping me. So everybody's different. So try to find your study plan, you know, find what makes you retain the information. For a lot of people, though, it's actually not reading. It could be listening. So that's another thing why you should sign up for my course if you want the help, because I have a video on every single topic, and typically the videos are about an hour long. So you're studying and listening to somebody else speak, because it's one thing to listen to your teachers, but then to listen to me and explain the same topic, but in a different way, you might go, oh, now it's starting to make sense, because you take what you learn in school, and then you take what you learn with me, and then it just sort of all comes together. So that may help you too. So if you find that you're not passing a lot of your classes, but you're thinking, oh my God, I've been studying so much, it's likely because you're not using the right method. So that's probably it. But if you have the opposite problem where you're not studying enough, well, you gotta study more, okay? A lot of students say to me, well, I have this, this, and this, and this. I don't have time to study. You have to make the time. That's the unfortunate thing, but you have to make the time. When I was a student, I worked part-time and full-time. Like, it was kind of a mix depending on the month and depending on how much schoolwork I had. But quite often, I would go to school for like 8 a.m. I'd be done around 3. And then I'd have to work at Subway, because that's where I used to work, from like 5 till 10 or 5 till 11 sometimes. So how the heck did I find time, right? Well, I would study on the way to my work, because I would have to take a bus, and then I'd have to take the Subway to work. It took me about an hour. So I would take that time to work and then back home to study. So I would be studying at least 2 hours every day. Did I want to? No. I would have much preferred to just sit on the bus, read a magazine, or talk to people, or just look out the window. I remember thinking when I was a student, I would be so happy to just look out the window and not have to think about anything. I would have been so happy to say, oh, I have nothing to do today. That would have been great. But as a student, there's always something to do. There's always something to learn. But you gotta study. School is not forever, but you have to do it right. So when you're in school, you gotta find the time to study. If you have kids, it's even harder, you guys. I know, I don't have kids, but I totally understand, but there's always a way. If you have to hire a babysitter for 2 hours, do it. Spend the extra money. If you don't have the money, use a credit card. Ask your mom, ask your dad, do what you have to do to make that happen, because this program is an investment in your future. It is, you guys. It's an investment in your future. You paid a lot of money to be a part of this program, so the next step is to pass it, right? So if you're not part of my tutoring courses, then at the very least, think of this as an investment, okay? So make sure to have the time to study. If you don't have the time, make the time. If you don't have the money to say hire somebody to help you, find the money, you guys. Use a credit card. Work more. Do what you have to do to make that money for the help. Because if you don't pass, all of your hard work means nothing. I'm sorry, but it means nothing, right? Your hard work means nothing. You have spent the money to take this program. So if you don't pass, that's a lot of money wasted. So so I hope that these tips helped. So you could be studying too much or not enough if you're not passing your tests or passing your exams. So I do hope, though, that these tips helped, and I hope I didn't sound too harsh, so I'm sorry if I did. But if I could find the time when I was in school having to work full-time, oh my gosh, I had to do so much. I was living away from home, so I was homesick. When I was in school, I tended to get sick a lot too. So I was always sick too, by the way, probably because I had to study so much. But if I can do it, you can do it. If I had a classmate of mine with three kids, a single mom. If she can pass it with honors, you can all pass it too. So if you need help, let me know, and I'll see you guys in the next video.